Hey developers, welcome back to the channel. Today we are diving into something really exciting and game-changing in the .NET ecosystem. .NET 9 is here. And you know, it comes with a significant change that is going to affect almost every API project we will be working on in .NET 9. Swagger UI is no more in .NET 9. I know that Swagger has been our trusted companion for documenting and testing APIs for quite some time now. I think starting from .NET 5. But wait, don't panic. There's going to be a great reason behind this. And Microsoft has provided us with a powerful new alternative that is known as an OpenAPI. So in this video, I'm going to explain why Microsoft made this move, and we will explore the new OpenAI integration that replaces Swagger UI. Plus, I'm going to show you how to create .NET 9 project and use this new OpenAPI approach, which is already integrated. You know that Swagger UI has been great, but it came with some limitations that Microsoft wanted to overcome it. The first one is tighter native integration. You know, Swagger UI is a third-party tool, and I believe you know that. It is not built or maintained by Microsoft team, by third party. And Microsoft wanted a solution that natively integrated into the .NET ecosystem. So with this OpenAI, the focus is shifted to first-class support for OpenAI. Now this allows tighter integration, faster update, and full support from Microsoft itself, making it much easier to manage and align with feature.NET features. The second reason here, it is a better control and customization. Microsoft wants to give us more control over how we document and expose APIs. So by moving to the new API built by the Microsoft, you now have greater flexibility in how you generate and customize your API documentation, allowing for more advanced use cases, especially in an enterprise scenarios. And then the last part here, it is to improve security and performance. You know, security is another big factor. Swagger UI, being a third-party tool, occasionally required extra layer of management to ensure proper security. But from shifting to OpenAPI directly in .NET, Microsoft can ensure better out-of-box security, and your API documentation won't compromise performance or expose any sensitive information unintentionally. Let's hop into our Visual Studio and let's see how to do it. Now, first, have to make sure you have .NET 9 installed. You know, .NET 9 is going to be released in November, right? So we are all waiting for it. Update your Visual Studio, which should download the .NET 9 SDK automatically. All that you need to do here is normally you create new project as what you have been doing since. And it is the same feature as you can see from .NET 8, 7, and so on. So we're going to have our API selected. So we give it a project name. Let's maintain the default one and a location. And as you can see, when it comes to the framework, that is where you need to make a change. Instead of .NET 8, you're going for .NET 9. So you can have this open API feature that I'm talking about. So you can see that we have our project created. Now when you go to solution, all what we want to focus here, it is a program.cs file. But well, before we tackle this, you make sure you can check from dependencies, and in there you go to your packages. Now you see that we have only OpenAPI package installed. We don't have Swash backup, right? Which contains the Swagger UI. Now when you check program.cs file, you can see from here that we have the OpenAI service registered. And after that, we are using the middleware pipeline. Although we do not have Swagger integrated, but it doesn't mean that you cannot manually integrate Swagger. You can install Swash backup and integrate app.use Swagger UI and now Swagger Gen. You can use it configure it as you did in .NET 8 and below, and it's going to work. Now let's go and run this and check it out. So you can see that as soon as the app launches, it has opened our endpoint. That is the weather forecast endpoint. Now, with the use of OpenAPI, there is no UI. A nice UI, as you can see in Swagger UI. You do not see that. If you want to read your OpenAPI documentation from your address in here, instead of navigating to the controller, you can go in for this OpenAPI. Then we have version1.json. So this will give you access to OpenAPI info. All right, so that is it. Stay tuned for the next update in .NET 9. Thank you and catch you up again.